We want to welcome you to the broadcast today. It is Wednesday, July the 21st, 2021. It's a great day the Lord hath made, and we ought to rejoice and be glad in it. Howdy, it's great to see you today. Thanks for tuning in, and I apologize that we weren't able to be with you yesterday, and we were definitely under the weather, and boy, vertigo, and just the whole nine yards yesterday. And some of you know what that's about. And so anyway, we're doing some better today. We thank the Lord for that. And so we're going forward, and we're glad we're able to be with you on the broadcast today. And of course, this is Wednesday. So we're looking forward to Wednesday night, looking forward to midweek service. And I mean that too, by the way, man, we are so excited about tonight. And I hope that you'll be there. We're going to be talking about a subject that I believe that everybody's going to go away maybe learning a little something tonight. And we're going to be talking about the end times. We're going to be talking about something very specific about the end times. And it is that thing that a lot of folks are very, very concerned about. And so anyway, that's all I'll say. That's your teaser for tonight. But I hope that you'll be in the service. We're going to start at 7 p.m. The doors will be open much sooner than that. And I encourage you to be there early. We'll have the coffee perking. We'll have the lemonade chilled. It'll be a good time of fellowship. And so I encourage you to be in the Lord's house tonight. Looking forward to a great, great time together at the Calvary Baptist Church. Just in case you're wondering, our physical address is 300 Indian Hill Road, Union Grove, North Carolina. And we tell people all the time, the difference is worth the distance. And so we're looking forward to what the Lord is going to do tonight. We're going to sing a little bit together. We're going to have a time of missions emphasis. We're going to be reading a letter from one of our great missionaries tonight. And then we're going to get right into the Word. And so anyway, God willing, looking forward to a great time. Hope you'll be there with us. And if you're planning on being there, send up some thumbs and some hearts. And we're excited about what the Lord is going to do. We're going to do some shout outs quickly. And then we're going to get into an announcement and then a giveaway. We're going to mention a giveaway today, a very important giveaway that you will not want to miss. All right, so hang in there with us just for a few moments. As I said, we are going to keep it very brief today. And so let's find out who is aboard, and then we'll go a little further today with the broadcast. We've got a good crowd on here. We thank the Lord for that. It looks like Stephanie Thacker's watching. Stephanie must be watching from Tennessee. And Stephanie, it looks like things are going so well at the Arise Youth Conference, and many of our folks are there, and my wife and I have so enjoyed watching the services by way of live stream, and man, it has been fantastic. And so Stephanie, we welcome you and any of the other folk that may be watching with you today. Rocky Bird's with us today, or as we fondly refer to him, Ricky. Ricky, good to see you today. And I hope you're having a great day today, my friend. God bless you. Karen Hoffman's watching. Karen, good to see you. I hope you're having a wonderful Wednesday today. Great to see you today. Tom Lampley's aboard. Tom, good to see you back on here with us on Countdown. Thanks for tuning in today. Phyllis Hudson's watching. Phyllis, great to see you. I hope you and Jackie are having a great day today. We've been praying for Jackie's sister. And anyway, good to see you, Phyllis. God bless you. Brother Lee is on here with us. Lee says, good evening, Calvary. Me, Jackson, Josh, and Rafe. And so hello, Lee, to you, Jackson, Josh, and Rafe today. And thank you guys for tuning into the broadcast. It's great to have you watching. The Hooks are watching all the way from Morganton, North Carolina. Barry, good to see you. I hope you guys are feeling better. And it's good to see you on the broadcast today. Patsy Bird is watching today. Patsy, good to see you. Hope you and Ronnie are having a blessed day today. The Gillies are aboard. It's great to see Donnie and Tamara, and we appreciate the Gillies in a big way. Jonathan Brown's watching today. Jonathan, good to see you. Hope you're having a great day today, my friend. We count you as a dear friend. Christine Edwards is watching. Christine, I hope you and Gary are having a blessed day today. So good to see you on here. Harrison Wabairu. There's Harrison, everybody. Harrison just checked in from Kenya. Harrison, good to see you, my friend. I hope you're having a wonderful, wonderful day. Great to see you, my dear friend. Let me see here. My beautiful, beautiful redhead is watching today. And I appreciate Miss Tammy. She's not been feeling so good either. We were both down for the count. And so I'm glad to see her up and about today. And so pray for Miss Tammy, if you will. That's a few. There may be others. You may see some folks I don't see. And so Countdown family, help me welcome everyone aboard today. And we thank you so much for tuning in. Well, let me see if I can take us to the split screens. and mention just a few things. Bible school is just a few days away. How can that be true? But it is. And I want you to be praying for our Vacation Bible School. Even if you can't come, I hope you'll pray for our Vacation Bible School. And I hope that you'll come. And we're looking forward to having a phenomenal time. Honestly and truly, I'm going to be honest with you. I think that our largest classes are going to be teenagers and adults. I think that's going to be our largest class. And so I want to encourage you to come. We've got a great crowd of workers that's helping. And we will be having an adult Vacation Bible School class each night. We'll have some wonderful Bible teachers that will be sharing the word each night, and it's going to be fantastic. And so anyway, we'll have refreshments and the whole nine yards. It's going to be good. I hope you'll plan on being there for Vacation Bible School. We'll march in 7 o'clock Monday night, Lord willing, and then the rest of the nights. And then Friday night, everything, Lord willing, will be out on the property. We'll have what we call our Friday night finale. We'll be having a huge cookout. We're going to have the coffee truck there. We're going to have an ice cream truck there. Hay rides, inflatables, bounce house. We're going to have the slide. We're going to have the dunk tank. We've got just all kinds of things that are going on that night. And we'll finish it all up, Lord willing, with a fantastic fireworks presentation. And so just come on out. We've got, God has given us one of the most beautiful spots right there in Union Grove. It is absolutely gorgeous as the sun is going down. And then when the sun gets down, we will be having fireworks, Lord willing. It's going to be great. And there is a chance we may even have a hot air balloon there on that Friday night. So anyway, a lot of things going on. I hope you'll be a part. And we're looking forward to what the Lord is going to do. Well, let me mention this to you real quickly, if I could. We're going to promote a Common Grounds coupon today. This is not just any coupon. This is $15. This is $15 today. So this is huge, all right? And so, excuse me. So we're going to give away a $15 store coupon credit. And now, if you win this, you'll have to come onto the property to spend it, okay? But this is big, $15. That's a lot, man. And so anyway, here's what you got to do. You've got to like and share the broadcast for the next 2 days, Thursday and Friday. And then Lord willing, my beautiful little redhead will take all those names. We will put those in a container and we will draw out a winner on Friday afternoon, God willing. All right. And so like and share. Now you may want to be sure that you comment in the comment section that you have shared, because sometimes because of the privacy settings with Facebook, we may or may not be able to see everybody who shares. So just comment, just play it safe and say, preacher, I shared it or I shared or whatever the case may be. And we'll draw out for a winner for this $15 store credit coupon on Friday. You can't beat that, Matt. You can't beat free. Amen. And this goes toward anything, even Bibles in our bookstore. We've got some fantastic Bibles. By the way, we have got we've got a brand new shipment of Bibles that may be in by this coming Sunday. And if you win this, wow, you may want to put it toward one of those brand new Bibles because they are absolutely gorgeous. That's all I'm going to say. But anyway, let's go ahead and get into the brief Bible lesson today, if we could. We're talking about why prayers go unanswered. And we've mentioned several things. We said, number one, because of a lack of asking. Truth of the matter is, our Bible says that sometimes we fail to get our prayers answered simply because we don't ask. We don't ask. And I want to take just a moment and just remind us that it's important that we ask about everything. Everything. There's nothing too big, nothing too small. Sometimes I think people get the idea that, you know what, that God's not interested in my smallness or my problem. The prophet Isaiah said about our Heavenly Father that He has graven us upon the palms of His hands. He cares about you. He loves you. He wants to hear about the things that are big in your life, but He wants to hear about the things that are very small in your life. And so ask about everything. Pray about everything, not just the big things, but pray about the small things as well. But sometimes our prayers go unanswered because of a lack of asking. But number two, sometimes our prayers go unanswered because of a location of sin, a location of sin. Now, I want to unpack that a little bit more today, if I could, because we have some more things that I was not able to get into, and I just felt like they were so important that they were too important to pass over. Sometimes our prayers go unanswered because of a location of sin. Now, don't forget, we gave you Psalm 66:18. The psalmist said, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. If I know that I have unconfessed sin that's in my life and I haven't got it right, God may not answer my prayers. Now, I'm going to be honest with you, and I think that just about every one of you can relate to what I'm about to tell you. I think one of the things that, one of the sad things that we have watched unfold during COVID and all the things that go along with COVID is we've seen a shortness of workers. And now, I don't know if that's because of COVID or because of the COVID stimulus packages that have went out. A lot of times, folks just don't want to work anymore. But one of the things that I've noticed is this, as I've had to call different companies and different businesses, I don't know if y'all can relate to this or not, but I've been put on hold many times. There have been times when I have stayed on hold for upwards of an hour and still didn't get through. And it seems like nowadays, when you call different places, you never get an answer. My wife and I were getting ready to go out to a restaurant the other night, and so I called just to see how long the wait was. And I called, and I let it ring and ring and ring and ring. Nobody answered. Nobody picked up. And part of that is because companies are trying to do more and more with less and less employees, and so a lot of times employees just don't have, they don't have the time to wait on tables and bus tables and answer the phone as well. And so the phone just goes unanswered. My point is this, that it's a disappointing thing to call and call and call and never get an answer, never get a response. And unfortunately, the truth of the matter is there are things that if we allow these things to come into our life, that will cause us to have our prayers go unanswered. And I want to just sort of build on that just a little bit today. We'll put just a few things on your screen today, if I could. And so, how about this? It's a clear Bible teaching that our actions can hinder us from getting our prayers answered. Now, we'll put a few things on the screen. Some of you are working, some of you are driving. You can go back and look these up if you want to. But how about 1 Peter chapter 3 and verse number 7? Listen to what our Bible says in 1 Peter 3, verse number 7. Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them, talking about your wives, dwell with them according to knowledge, giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life. Look at this part. That your prayers be not hindered. That your prayers be not hindered. Fellas, you know what that's saying? That if we don't treat our wife like Christ loved the church, then there's a very good possibility that our prayers are going to be answered. Listen, don't expect to treat your spouse like dirt and to drag them through the mud and to talk to them like they're nothing, and then go to your Heavenly Father and expect to get your prayers answered. My dear friend, according to the authority of the Word of God, it's not going to happen. God wants to hear your prayers, and God wants to answer your prayers, but He expects you and I to live up to a certain standard, if you will. And so the Bible says there that if we mistreat our spouse, and this is specifically talking to husbands right here, that if we mistreat our wives, that our prayers can surely go unanswered. Let me give you another reference today. How about Proverbs 21 and verse number 13? Listen to this. The Bible says, whoso stoppeth his ears at the cry of the poor, he also shall cry himself, but shall not be heard. Now, we talked about this a little bit Sunday night in our service. We talked about being a servant, and the Bible says here that if people come to us in need, and we stop our ears to their cry, God said, be careful because I may stop my ear to your cry. And so when we are not willing to help those who are in need, it causes our prayers to go unanswered. Hey, again, this is just, we're just sort of emphasizing a point here, but the scripture has numerous, it talks about this numerous times. And so let me give you another one. How about Proverbs chapter 28? And verse number 9, listen to this one. The Bible says, he that turneth away his ear from hearing the law or the word of God, even his prayer shall be abomination. And so when we turn away from hearing the word of God, the Bible says our prayer is not going to be answered. When we're reading the word of God and the Spirit of God really brings out something in your heart or life, and yet you turn away from that thing, God says, be careful, because that will hinder your prayer from being answered. Or if you walk into a Bible preaching church and the man of God gets up there that day and he really gives what God wants him to give, and it really ministers to your heart, and yet you turn away from the truth, the Bible says, my dear friend, that that can hinder you and I from getting our prayers answered. And so, again, our actions can hinder us from getting our prayers answered. But let me end on a very positive note today. How about this? That if we will live according to the Word of God, if we will do our best to get plugged into the things of the Lord, and if we'll make sure that we do our best to be in church when we can be in church, when we read our Bibles and spend time in prayer, and when we try to walk with our God. And you know what the Bible says? The Bible says that God will most definitely hear and answer our prayers. John 15, verse 7, listen to what it says. The Bible says, if ye abide in me, the Lord said, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be. It doesn't say you. It might. It doesn't say there's a chance, but the Bible says, and it shall be done unto you. And so again, the point being this, that if we'll live according to the will of God, God said, I delight in hearing your prayers, and I delight in answering your prayers. It's the favor of God, my dear friend. And so I'm so glad to report to you that you and I, we can receive answers to prayer. Well, hey, listen, let me do this today. If I could, I want to put a number or some numbers on your screen. It's our prayer helpline number, 704-327-5662. 704-327-5662. If you're watching this broadcast today and you don't know Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, if you're watching today and you don't know that you know that you're on your way to heaven, I want you to reach for your phone right now, and I want you to call us. I want you to call us. We've set this number up just for you, and I want you to call us. If no one picks up immediately, I want you to leave a message. Leave a message, and you keep trying until you can leave a message and leave your callback number. We want to call you, and we want to give you some wonderful scriptures on how you can know Christ as Savior and how you can know you're going to spend eternity in heaven. Now, if you can't get through on that first number, call the second one, 704-539-5340. And again, you leave a message, and myself or one of our prayer helpline workers wants to call you, and we want to try to be a blessing to you. If you're watching this broadcast today and you've got a heavy burden and it feels like it's 10 million pounds, and you say, Brother Pope, I don't know if I can make it much longer, please call us. We want to walk through that valley with you, and sometimes it helps to have someone walk through a valley with you. We want to walk through it with you, and we would love to pray with you and trust God with you. And so please call that number today. And then all of our countdown family, don't forget, be kind to everyone, because everyone's having a tough time. Let's lift up one another. And then Calvary family, we cannot wait to see you in just a little while. 7 o'clock. It's going to be great. And so listen, have a great rest of the day. We look forward to seeing you tomorrow at this same time, Lord willing. God bless, and you take care.